Hello everybody, it's Mark here. Just want to let you know we're going to be working on a drawing today of a character from Tim Burton's version of a Disney movie called Frankenweenie. This is a little character. He's really simple in my opinion. Might be a really good thing for you to draw, you know, try and follow along with. He's got great shapes to him that make up this whole character. His name is Edgar E. Gore. And so it's a play on the word Igor, which was Frankenstein's assistant. Anyway, if you've seen the movie, you know who I'm talking about. He's a great character. Tim Burton's got a great imagination for characters and character design. Anyway, you should have fun drawing this one right along with me. And if you feel I'm going too fast, just rewind the movie, rewind the video and pause it and draw at your own pace. So please keep watching. Thanks.
Okay, so we're going to start off drawing Edgar E. Gore. All right, so we're just going to do, and I might go ahead and do his whole body. I'm just going to do maybe a upper torso here, but there's not really much to him, so we'll just go ahead and do his whole body here. So just follow along if you like. Start off with a... just kind of get his head placed in here. Weird shape this head, just like all of Tim Burton's characters. Then right here is where his back starts. You got that hunchback Igor thing going there. It's almost like drawing a... I'm getting the feel of drawing like a cupcake. I don't know. It's weird. I've got a photo over here I'm looking at for reference. Just in case you're wondering how I'm coming up with this. Shorts he's got on. And your lines don't have to be perfect or anything. This is the great thing about drawing cartoon characters. For the most part, they don't really have a, especially when they're wearing tattered clothes, they're just all over the place here. So this is almost like drawing a candy corn here. A triangle with a round top on. That's his sleeve. It's gonna be his left sleeve. And so let's see, we draw a line here. Sometimes I do this right here just to kind of give me an idea of you just kind of split up his face here to give him an idea of where things should go. So this is the direction. This is the middle of his face. This right here representing where the top of his nose will be right here. Let me go ahead and draw that in there. It's just a little small pig snout looking thing. Two watermelon seeds for nostrils. And I'm going to draw these bony arms. He's got arms almost like a skeleton. It's most of Tim Burton's characters, they're usually bony. These big bulky bodies, but they have at least this one does anyway. He's got a big bulky body, but he's it's crazy. His hand, his top of his hand, he's got these crazy little twisted fingers. I got a bad case of arthritis. Be just a little kid. Drawing those fingers there. And now we're going to draw the legs. He's got these bony legs, just like his arms. Bunched up socks at the bottom. He looks kind of bow-legged, don't he? That's part of his character, I guess. Alright, so there we got that. Here, we're gonna put some stripes on his socks here. Details in later. At the bottom of his thing, his sweater, looks like he cut it himself. It doesn't look like it's wore out, it's just almost like he took scissors to it and cut it himself. He wanted that tattered look. Go ahead and erase this line here. This line here, where his body line was coming through there at arm. Just that one. There's no mistakes. Some these here. Yep. And let's get to his face here. Let's get this character some face. This face in character. snaggliest tooth teeth I've ever seen. Part in the middle there. Another thing to keep in mind is when you're doing things like this, you know, you don't have to be so set on what the photograph actually looks like as opposed to what you're doing, but it helps a lot in the beginning to learn your spacing in between things. That's how you can get a good idea of how much space is in between here and compared to what you're actually drawing from. Everything's about measurements basically. But you know, you just gotta develop your own sight for seeing things a different way as far as where the placement of certain objects go. That's Edgar E. Gore. That's the pencils. We'll start the inking process up next. Okay, so we're going to do a little bit of shading first. These characters were done in black and white when they were, but it's filmed in black and white. Not really a set color for the characters that I'm aware of, so we're just going to be using some gray and black. Erase a little bit of this, some of these lines, so they don't end up in the final drawing there. Erase your. Fortunately, with a Tim Burton style character, grade 40% present color here. you know, all I'm doing here is filling in stripes. When you're doing this, you have to pay attention. You have to kind of imagine that you're going ahead and drawing all the way across here. So this, since this sleeve right here interferes with this line, draw your line right here, and then pick your marker up and drop it right back down where it would continue. Same thing with the bottom here, right here. Pick it up, go past the sleeve. Of it. That way, visually, it looks like the complete line is there and you didn't. Because otherwise, the stripes are going to be all messed up. Not look like the pattern that they are. I'm using kind of a dried out marker for this, just to give it in. Rougher vintage look to it, because his characters seem to have a vintage look to them anyway. They I'm assuming he does that on purpose. Alright, so I'm just going to leave this sweater that way there. That's enough of the grays. Work on this here. hope you're still with me. I'm just concentrating on these lines here. I really want this to turn out nice. It's a sometimes I tend to rush stuff and then end up throwing it away because I don't like it. Okay, so that's Edgar E. Gore. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you followed along. I would love to see some of your work. If you decide to follow along, I'd love to see what you did with this. Please send me a message or leave a comment, maybe post something, I don't know if it lets you post it, but feel free to email me your work if you'd like me to look at it and critique it for you. And you can send that to markwrightart1970@gmail.com. And I'll be glad to get back with you. Thank you very much. I hope you subscribe, give it a like, and tell your friends. Thank you very much.